Voters in Boston are getting ready for a major shakeup in their city's politics. Tomorrow's election and the race for mayor narrows the field to two finalists. One thing won't change. All the contenders in this nonpartisan election are left of center. But as Jeffrey Brown reports, the face of leadership looks different this year. It's part of our Race Matters series.
Meet the mayor, the old one, always a white male, and for 90 years, all but one Irish.
Let's make sure we get it done.
But look now. Change is in the air in Boston, where the top candidates this year are all women of color who serve on the city council. Acting Mayor Kim Janey and Andrea Campbell, both black. Michelle Wu, Taiwanese-American. Anissa Asaibi George, daughter of Tunisian and Polish parents.
Hey, Angel.
To many, like Cheryl Clyburn Crawford, it's a watershed moment. She grew up here and now heads Mass Vote, aimed at increasing voter participation in communities of color.
At one point, we could not see ourselves. A female, a black female mayor, that just wasn't in the cards. We didn't see it. As the demographics change and the city is more, is becoming more, you know, mixed, diverse, people see themselves in their role, in those roles, and say, I can, right? Like, that role is open for me.
This is a city of rich history, but part of that history involves deep racism. When I was growing up in this area, one of my childhood heroes was Bill Russell, one of the great basketball players with the Boston Celtics. He would write years later in a memoir with bitterness of his experience as a black man here, calling Boston a flea market of racism. So one question posed now, how much has the city really changed? In the 1970s busing era, overt violence. Today, continued economic disparities. A study by the Federal Reserve Bank of Boston found the median net worth for non-immigrant black households in the metropolitan area was just $8, compared to $250,000 for whites.
Boston has quite a reputation as a racist city.
It
racist
does.
Past. Is it deserved?
Yes, very much so. You know, I grew up here. I went to school here, I left, and I came back after 25 years. And in a different shape, in a different form, but it still exists. And I think we're working on it. I feel hopeful.
These are the 411 kits with all the information about the different campaigns that we're working on.
Crawford's group is nonpartisan and doesn't back specific candidates. But she says an election amid a pandemic gives all of them and voters a need to respond.
I think with COVID last year, 2020, ripping the Band-Aid off and exposing all the inequities that exist within our communities, that we have a real opportunity to make change.
Thriving church, the hub of this neighborhood.
The old way in Boston revolved around tight-knit neighborhood institutions like the Catholic Church. Larry DeCara learned that as a politician himself in many roles, beginning in the 1970s as a city councilor and candidate for mayor. We met him outside Blessed Sacrament, shuttered since 2004 in the Jamaica Plain neighborhood.
When I arrived in Jamaica Plain, there were four Catholic churches and four Catholic schools. Today, there are two Catholic churches.
Today, Jamaica Plain is a more gentrified community, new businesses mixed with old, and its own Whole Foods.
And many of these buildings are now occupied by young single people who aren't from here.
Yeah.
And they will
don't have those roots.
Don't have the roots, don't even know what church they're supposed to go to. Very, very different.
But people don't have those roots, but they also don't have the political roots.
Don't have the political roots because they don't know that Maura Hannigan's father was in the state senate and her grandfather was before him.
Yeah.
They just don't know those things.
Yeah.
In another part of the city, Dorchester's Fields Corner, immigrants, most from Vietnam, have helped revitalize a neighborhood in decline.
I've seen it within just a few years after they built the thing.
Paul Watanabe, a political scientist at the University of Massachusetts Boston, brought us to the Vietnamese American Community Center.
And what they did is they came here and they found the rents cheap and they found an opportunity here and they really built a community here. This is a city, for example, that was on a decline. Up until the most recent censuses, for example, we saw the population of Boston going down, not increasing. And we've seen the growth of the city take place under one explanation, and that is immigration. Immigration is really what has added to the vibrancy of the city in a large degree.
It helped bring it back.
It helped bring it back.
Well, I might send you to St. George's this time. It's up on the hill, and it's easy to have the distance.
What will happen? In West Roxbury, Rachel Polliner, head of the local chapter of Progressive Massachusetts, is backing current frontrunner Michelle Wu, who happens to be originally from Chicago. But today, Polliner thinks, Bostonians vote more on issues like affordable housing and homelessness due to the opioid crisis rather than old ties.
We have questionnaires that go out to candidates. We interview the candidates. We have forums. And I think all of those things contribute. The political conversation is shifting over the last decade more to issues and policies and problem solving.
For Paul Watanabe, there's a chance Boston itself will move from national political laggard to leader.
If you think about northern industrial cities, most of them have had a black mayor before. And I will argue that the leadership that emerges from this election is going to be one that has, I hope, a national impact on this debate, not only about what happens in Boston, but how we get a nation that is going to look like Boston soon, a majority-minority nation that, again, has leadership that reflects that new reality.
Tuesday's preliminary election will narrow the field to two, who then go head-to-head in November. As appears all but certain, the winner will reflect the face of change. For the PBS NewsHour, I'm Jeffrey Brown in Boston.